गुड मॉर्निंग टू ऑल ऑफ यू। दिस इज राजू सर। ब्रीफ यू अबाउट द लिम्फैटिक ड्रेनेज ऑफ द लोअर लिम्स टुडे। So the objectives of today's lecture, as per the previous questions, to describe the competencies, describe the microanatomy of lymph node, demonstrate the landmarks for palpation, mention the normal size of lymph node. So these are the things which we must learn about. And the lymphatic drainage of the lower limb plays a very important role clinically. This is the general anatomy of the lymphatic system, which we know already, the lymphatic capillaries. This is a drainage, lymphatic drainage, lymphatic capillaries, from the lymphatic capillaries to the lymphatic vessels, then the lymph node, then the efferent vessels, then lymphatic trunk or collecting duct, and finally drains into the left or right subclavian vein. The length from 1 to 25 millimeters length it has. Lymph node we are speaking about. Here we can see the structure of the lymph node. This is general anatomy, which we had learned already. Again, once again, we'll have a look over the lymph node structure. These are the afferents through which the lymph will reach the lymph node, where it can be filtered. And then through the efferent vessels, it comes out. And it may be afferent for another lymph node. So now we'll see the cortex and the germinal center, the capsule, subcapsular sinus, trabecula, hilum, medullary sinus, the medullary cords and all. Next. Then this here in this case, regarding the lower limb, we can see two types of lymph nodes. One is superficial, another one is deep type of lymph nodes. Superficial one and deep. One set of lymph nodes are on superficial. Another set of lymph nodes are on the deep. The superficial lymph nodes, we can see in the diagram. Superficial lymph nodes drain the skin and fascia of the lower limb, the perineum and the trunk below the umbilical plane. I repeat, superficial lymph nodes drain the skin and fascia of the lower limb below the perineum and the trunk below the umbilical plane. So these are responsible for draining the below the umbilical plane and the perineum and the skin and fascia of the lower limb. So these are responsible for that. Here in this diagram, you can see, so, as we know, the lymphatic system is accessory to the venous system. So definitely it accompanies the veins, the lymphatic vessels. So here you can see the great saphenous vein. So along which you can trace the group of lymph nodes. These are, you can see here in this diagram itself, there are the superficial group of lymph nodes. This is a small saphenous vein. This is a great saphenous vein. Great saphenous vein accompanied by the vertical group, lower vertical group, we call it as superficial, under superficial inguinal lymph nodes. We can see 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 lymph nodes we could find. Then the horizontally located, you can see two groups, medial group and the lateral group. Here we must understand the medial group. Here you can locate, so as per the surface landmarking, this is the inguinal area, and here it is the pubic tubercle and the anterior superiliac spine. In between there is a extension called as Paupart ligament or the inguinal ligament, and here is the medial group of lymph nodes, two are there, and the lateral group of lymph nodes, three are located here. This is what in the diagram we can get. So now we'll explain in detail. Now we understand that upper group consists of the two subgroups like medial and the lateral. Sometimes they are called as medial group, lateral group and vertical group. There are three groups we can find, three groups of superficial lymph nodes. The efferents from all these superficial inguinal lymph nodes pierce the cribriform fascia and terminate in the deep inguinal lymph nodes. So finally, these efferents will reach the deep inguinal lymph nodes. A few may pass directly to the external iliac nodes. I repeat, efferents from the all superficial inguinal lymph nodes pierce the cribriform fascia and terminate in the deep inguinal nodes. A few may pass directly to the external iliac nodes. And the upper group of in detail explanation, we'll see the in detail explanation about the upper group of lymph nodes. We call them as horizontal group. We could recall the diagram. The lateral receive lymph from the gluteal region, adjoining anterior abdominal wall below the umbilicus. Lateral group are receiving the lymph from the gluteal region, adjoining anterior abdominal wall below the umbilicus. The upper lateral we'll explain in detail once again. It is placed below the lateral part of the inguinal ligament, yes, we had noticed it, and contains about two or three nodes we had noticed in the diagram. They drain the skin and fascia of the upper part of the lateral side of the thigh, of the buttock, the flank, and the back below the umbilical plane. So I repeat, this is placed below the lateral part of the inguinal ligament and contains about two or three lymph nodes. They drain the skin and fascia of the upper part of the lateral side of the thigh, the buttock, the flank, and the back below the umbilical plane. The medial group, what about the medial group? The medial group lymph nodes are subcutaneous tissue. They drain the subcutaneous tissue of the anterior abdominal wall below the umbilicus. Penis, including prepuce and scrotum in male, vulva and vagina below the hymen in females. Perineum and lower part of the anal canal below the pectinate line. A few uterine lymphatics which accompany the round ligament of the uterus. So this is in detail explanation about the medial group of lymph nodes. There they drain the subcutaneous tissue of the anterior abdominal wall below the umbilicus. The penis, including the prepuce and scrotum in male, vulva and vagina below the hymen in females. Perineum and lower part of the anal canal below the pectinate line. A few uterine lymphatics which accompany the round ligament of the uterus. It is placed below the medial end of the inguinal ligament that we noticed in the diagram. We recall the diagram once again. Along the course of the superficial lymphatic vessels or the venous vessels, the group contains two or three nodes which drain the anterior abdominal wall below the umbilical, then the perineum including the external genitalia, except the glans penis, anal canal below the pectinate line, and vagina below the hymen, penile part of the male urethra, superolateral angle of the uterus via the round ligament. So these are the two, three lymph nodes on the medial aspect, which drain the anterior abdominal below the umbilicus, perineum, anal canal below the pectinate line. Here we have to notice one thing, that including the external genitalia, except the glands, then the anal canal below the pectinate line, vagina below the hymen, superolateral angle, penile part of the male urethra, then superolateral angle of the uterus via the round ligament. Here, the lymphatics of testes do not drain into the inguinal lymph nodes. They will be draining into the parietic lymph nodes. Then the lower vertical group, four or five in number. Accompany the lateral side of the termination of the great saphenous vein. We could recall the diagram once again. Four or five in number, which we had noticed, accompany the lateral side of the termination of the great saphenous vein. Laterally, we had noticed. It received afferent from the all superficial lymph vessels of the lower limb, except the vessels that follow the small saphenous vein, which end in the popliteal nodes. This group of lymph nodes are placed along both sides of the terminal part of the great saphenous vein and contains about four or five nodes that we have noticed. They drain the skin and fascia of the lower limb, except the buttocks and except the short saphenous territory. A few lymphatics accompanying the short saphenous vein cross the leg, accompany the great saphenous vein and drain into this group of nodes. We repeat once again, the lateral group of lymph nodes, four or five in number, accompany the lateral side of the termination of the great saphenous vein. They receive afferents from the all superficial lymph vessels of the lower limb, except the vessels that follow the small saphenous vein, which end in the popliteal nodes. They are placed along the both sides of the terminal part of the great saphenous vein and accompanying there are four or five in number. They drain the skin and fascia of the lower limb except the buttock and except the short saphenous territory. A few lymphatics, only few lymphatics will accompany the short saphenous vein, cross the leg, accompany the great saphenous vein and drain into this group of lymph nodes. Different vessels from all superficial lymph nodes drain into the external iliac nodes. To repeat, external vessels from all superficial lymph nodes drain into the external iliac nodes. The deep inguinal lymph nodes. The deep inguinal lymph nodes vary from 1 to 3 in number, lie on the medial side of the femoral vein. Superficial lymph nodes, we came to know, there are three groups in number, vertical group, horizontal, medial and lateral. These are the deep group of lymph nodes. Vary from 1 to 3 in number, lie on the medial side of the femoral vein. Now we go a little bit deeper. We think about the femoral triangle, which we had located vein, artery and nerve from medial to lateral, where the great saphenous vein is draining into. So that's a deep, after crossing the cribriform fascia, we could locate the femoral vein. The lowest one is situated below the junction of the great saphenous vein and the femoral vein. Only three, na? We're discussing about only three. The lowest one is situated below the junction of the great saphenous vein and the femoral vein, first one. The middle in the femoral canal, this is called as gland of Plockett or Rosenmüller. Middle in the femoral canal. Femoral canal is the sheath covered canal in which we could find the one lymph node, which we call it as gland of lymph node or lymph node of gland of Plockett or lymph node of Rosenmüller. The highest in the lateral part of the femoral ring within the femoral septum. Within the septum, we could find one more lymph node. So we repeat, they may be vary from one or three. At least one we could find. The lowest one is situated below the junction of the great saphenous vein and femoral vein. The middle in the femoral canal, that is the gland of Plockett or lymph node of Plockett or Rosenmüller. The highest in the lateral part of the femoral ring within the femoral septum. Next, here you can see in this diagram, this is the femoral sheath, funnel shaped one. The femoral vein, femoral artery, which could be found inside the sheath. And first part, this one is green colored one, is the lymphatic and lymph node. And it is a femoral canal. Here you can see the same one, the horizontal cross section. You can find the lymph node, vein, and the artery. And lymph node, vein, and the artery. These are about deep inguinal lymph nodes. Once again, we'll discuss in detail. Afferent vessels received from the deep lymph nodes which accompany the femoral vessels, glans penis or glans clitoris. We, while studying the superficial ones, we had the exception. This was the glans penis and the glans clitoris, which will be draining into the deep inguinal lymph nodes. A few efferent vessels from the superficial inguinal lymph nodes, they can be the afferents for the deep inguinal lymph nodes. The lymph from the glans penis or glans clitoris is drained into the deep inguinal lymph nodes located in the femoral canal. That is called as lymph node of Plockett or Rosenmüller. We repeat, lymph from the glans penis or the glans clitoris drain into the deep inguinal lymph nodes located in the femoral canal. That is called as a lymph node of Plockett or the Rosenmüller. And they accompany the arteries and drain into the deep inguinal lymph nodes present inside the femoral sheath, which in turn drain into the iliac lymph nodes inside the pelvis and aortic lymph nodes in the lower posterior abdominal wall. So they accompany the arteries and drain into the deep inguinal lymph nodes present inside the femoral sheath, which in turn drain into iliac lymph nodes inside the pelvis and aortic lymph nodes in the lower posterior abdominal wall. Efferents from the deep inguinal lymph nodes drain into the external iliac lymph nodes. Now we come to the last objective of lecture. This is called a clinical anatomy. Basically, we find three important clinical aspects, applied aspects. One is a hard skin. Another one is fibrotic tissue, then non-pitting edema. Edema is a swelling with the interstitial fluid. So it is usually believed that in a healthy person, lymph nodes are not visible and palpation is not available or not possible. Repeat, it is usually believed that in a healthy person, lymph nodes are not visible and palpation is not available, not possible. In practically healthy people, due to small, sometimes inconspicuous injuries of the skin of the lower limbs, small or pea-sized inguinal lymph nodes can be palpable. Healthy people, thin people, lean people, we can call them. We'll specify the number and size and consistency of enlarged lymph nodes. So as per the criteria which we had studied, 2 to 1 to 3 deep inguinal lymph nodes can be identified in a superficial group. Vertically, 4 or 5 lymph nodes can be located, and medially you can find 2 lymph nodes, and laterally 3 lymph nodes. This is our size, and the number and consistency can be specified before palpating. This is a palpating methodology which we are discussing. The palpation of the lymph nodes is carried out by the tips of a slightly bent fingers, usually the second and the fifth fingers of both hands. Second and the fifth fingers of both hands. Gently, carefully, with light sliding movements, because if there is a lymph node or lymphadenitis, definitely there will be tenderness, pain and all. So that's why we palpate very much carefully, gently, sliding with the sliding movements as though rolling through the lymph nodes. The inguinal lymph nodes are probed in the area of the inguinal or femoral triangle in a direction transverse to the pauport ligament. Pauport ligament means inguinal ligament. An increase in inguinal lymph nodes can occur with various inflammatory processes in the lower extremities, the anus and the external genitalia. The inguinal lymph nodes are probed in the area of the inguinal or femoral triangle in a direction transverse to the pauport ligament. An increase in inguinal lymph nodes can occur with various inflammatory processes in the lower extremities, the anus, the external genitalia. This is how we can see the applied anatomy regarding the lymphatic system of the lower limb, especially if there is any obstruction of the lymphatics leads to the elephantiasis. First one thing here, you can observe the leg of a person, which is abnormal, like an elephant, so swelling and all you can see. Here also you can see another elephantiasis. Both legs are affected with the elephantiasis. Thank you very much. This is about the lymphatic system or the lymphatic drainage of the lower limb, in which we'll summarize. The superficial includes the vertical group, which are 4 or 5 in number, and medial and lateral, medial 2 and lateral 3 are in number. And the deep inguinal lymph nodes are 1, 2, 3 in number, in which in femoral canal, we notified or identified the lymph node of Plockett or Rosenmüller, which is a very important one. So the finally clinical anatomy includes the elephantiasis, which is very important. And we had discussed about the palpation, how to palpate the inflamed lymph nodes. So this is about the lymphatic system of, or the lymphatics of the lower limb. Thank you very much.